Thanks for joining me again as we learn about constructing and managing networks for Dante audio systems. We've recently learned about VLANs and Dante optimization and seen how Yamaha switches make it quick and easy to set up. Now, we're going to look at connecting multiple switches together to build larger systems. And we will learn about using link aggregation to increase our bandwidth. I'll also give you some tips about network cables. But first, let's talk about trunks. A trunk is a link between two network switches which can carry a number of VLANs. Remember last time we created two or three VLANs to segment a switch for different types of data that shouldn't be mixed. Well, imagine we have two switches set up like that in different locations, and we need to connect all the equipment together. You may think it needs three cables, one for each VLAN, but actually just one cable is enough when it's set up as a trunk. The trunk will carry the data of several VLANs from one switch to another without mixing it up. Data from VLAN 1 ports in the first switch will only reach VLAN 1 ports in the second switch. Same for the other VLAN data. They will only reach the ports associated with the same VLAN. Let's see how to set it up. I have two switches here already programmed with three VLANs each. Connect them together using one port in each switch that's currently assigned to VLAN 1, which is the default VLAN, used for management tasks like this. Then I can program both switches from the same connection. Consider the best port to use for a trunk. If it carries multiple VLANs, it might require additional bandwidth. If you have 10 gig ports, it makes sense to use them as trunks. If you have fiber optic ports, you could use them for a longer distance trunk. Otherwise, a standard copper port may be used, but remember the strict 100 meter limitation. Never exceed that with Cat5e, Cat6 or 7 cables. Actually, let's consider the best cables to use, as it's particularly important with trunks that they can carry a lot of data. The cable needs to be in good condition. If it's bent or squashed or stretched, its bandwidth capability can suffer. For gigabit networks, use Cat5e or Cat6 cables. Standard Cat5 is not good enough. Cat7 has an additional shielding built in, which makes it harder to install, so that's not always appropriate. One important point about cables for mobile systems is whether the copper in the cable is solid or stranded. Stranded cable has many small hairs of copper inside. It makes the cable more flexible, so it can go around tighter corners or lay nice and flat on the floor of a stage. However, it will be less efficient with data transmission and might not work over distances approaching 100 meters. So, solid copper cores in the cable are better suited to trunks covering distances of 50 meters or more. Most reels of low-cost installation cable are solid copper and so are quite suitable if they're not going to be run over or be the cause of a trip hazard. Of course, fiber optic cables have a distance advantage, up to 550 meters for multi-mode at 1 gigabit per second, 300 meters at 10 gig, and 10 kilometers for single-mode fiber at either speed. Remember, you need the same type of fiber module at each end and a matching cable type. And you cannot link a 10 gig port to a 1 gig port. It must be like for like. There are several grades of fiber quality. For multi-mode, use OM3 or 4. OM1 and 2 are lower grade and so are not suitable. The fiber must have a core diameter of 50 micrometers and cladding of 125 micrometers. For single mode, use either OS1 or OS2. Both are suitable with a smaller 9 micrometer core and 125 micrometer cladding. Both single and multi-mode fiber modules can be fitted into the SWR switches, and the two larger models of SWR2310 can handle 10 gig modules. SWP1 only comes with 1 gig multi-mode fiber ports, while SWP2 has both options with the higher capacity 10 gig ports. So, take care to select the appropriate model. Now let's get back to trunks. Remember, we want to connect 3 VLANs between 2 switches. First, we should program the far switch. Otherwise, if you change the local switch first, it may block your access to the far switch. From Yamaha's LAN monitor software, remember, the switches are automatically discovered without needing to know their IP addresses. Using the web GUI, open the detail settings and the VLAN menu. The operation mode of all the ports is probably set to access. Highlight the port you wish to use as a trunk to link between the two switches. Press setting and change the operation mode to trunk. Then you can select the additional VLANs to assign. Keep the default VLAN 1 as the native VLAN, which is used for network monitoring and programming, as we are doing now. Click confirm. Now, do the same with the local switch at the near end of the trunk. Select the port to convert into a trunk and assign the additional VLANs. Now, devices in VLAN 2 from both switches will be able to communicate with each other without interfering with any devices in VLAN 1. The data is kept quite separate. May I remind you again, though, to keep an eye on the bandwidth. Use LAN monitor, select the switch, and click the bandwidth tab. You certainly don't want to go beyond 80% to stay safe. If you're running Dante at 96 kHz, then more bandwidth will be used for each channel. So in that case, consider to use switches with 10 gigabit links, such as the SWP2 and the larger SWR2310 devices. This 28GT model is particularly useful with 4 10 gig modules available. So you could use that as a central switch linking to 4 others in different places. If using 10 gig is not an option, and 1 gig may not be enough, there's a trick you can utilize. Link aggregation. This allows you to use 2 or 3 or more ports to link between the same pair of switches, creating a 2 gig or 3 gig or larger connection. SWP1 and SWP2 switches already have this programmed into Dante presets A and B for the pair of fiber ports. And preset B includes another link for the highest numbered copper ports, allowing an additional increased bandwidth switch connection. To create a link aggregation with the SWR2300 switches or with an SWP2 switch in user config mode, go to the web GUI again. Bear in mind, this is more difficult with the SWP1, where link aggregation can only be set by using a Dante preset or programming via the command line interface. Start with one cable link between the two switches and program the far switch first to avoid any communication interruptions. Open the detailed settings menu and select link aggregation. In the interface list, click on the new icon. Then select the associated ports, including the port which is already being used to connect this switch. Type a description in the explanation field if you wish. Confirm and click OK. Do the same for the switch at the near end of the link. Select the same number of ports, though the ports could have different numbers. And now you can connect the specified ports with additional cables without the switches starting up their loop protection. Refresh the web GUI and monitor the link status. We've achieved a lot in this session. Trunks and link aggregation. I hope you've enjoyed it. Next time, we're going to explore different ways of building redundancy into your network to keep you covered in case of a cable failure or even the loss of a whole switch. I'll be back soon.